Hi, everybody. Welcome to Video Gold. Today, we're going to do some traveling. We'll take you from a country barn dance jam to the snowy streets of Georgetown, Colorado. But first, we're going live in concert to a song from the Standard record that asks the musical question, who's in the house? Now, I hope you have the right answer. It's about to get exciting.
Came into my house, and became real to me.
The most that he's brought into my house is love. He's just showed me what love is and what it's like to be loved, truly be loved.
Yeah, I was saved when I was about 7 or 8, and ever since then, life wasn't real hard at 8-year-old, but I couldn't imagine what it would be like now without him in my life.
He's the man in my house, Jesus Christ, and he's in my heart. He's the man in my heart.
I don't have to have the stress of wonder what I'm going to do with my life or where I'm going to go, because I know who I am and I know where I'm going.
It's like a constant hunger and a constant thirst just to know the Lord and to see the miraculous miracles that He performs every single day. There's a new awakening. Every single day there's something miraculous going.
Jesus Christ, the Holy Ghost is in my house.
What Jesus Christ did for me is actually filled that void, that filled that emptiness that I felt within me, that felt as though I was unwanted, unloved.
He guides me and He leads me. He speaks to me, and I commune with Him. As I commune with Him, as I seek after Him, He responds in the same manner as I do.
I think it boils down to a hope, you know, something that I have which keeps me going day by day. If you have it, it's like a lifestyle. It's going to come out every day, and it's something that I want to be contagious in my life. I want it to be running over so that when people see it, they see something in me that they want to emulate.
I never thought much about dance as a form of ministry. I'd already recorded 14 records, did 10 years worth of touring as a solo artist, so every year I'd see tens of thousands of people come to Christ, and God was giving me the songs to do it with. So I figured that's all I needed. But as the years rolled on, I began to see the necessity to bring the artistic side up to the level of the spiritual side of things. Actually, we began by adding stage sets to our concerts, very much like a Broadway play. People seemed to respond even more to the message. And then the idea to add dance hit me like a ton of bricks. The world has used dance to punctuate its message for years. I mean, think about it. Shows like American Bandstand, Solid Gold, Soul Train, all use dance as a visual exclamation point to the message in the music. I searched the scriptures and found 27 references to dancing. 2 Samuel 6:14 tells us how David danced before the Lord with all his might. Psalm 149:3 says, "Let them praise his name in the dance." Well, that did it for me. I mean, if it was a principle of scripture, it needed to be a principle of ministry. So starting from the Addicted to Jesus record on, dance as a form of ministry was in. My main problem was I wasn't a dancer, so I had to learn. In this case, it was line dancing, which is supposed to be easy, but it took me weeks to learn what you'll see on the screen. So on a ridiculously cold morning on the 4th of January, starting at 7 a.m., with space heaters blasting from six different directions to keep us from getting frostbite, Margaret Becker, myself, and a cast of very dedicated country music buffs danced out a message of hope and encouragement to a song from the Standard record that told people that no matter how bad things look, to keep holding on to God's unchanging hand.
They said I'd never make it. They said I would not last a day.
Holding on.
Holding On just represents to me, hold on to the gospel, hold on to that knowledge, the truth that the words represent, the truth and the word of God. Hold on, when all else fails, just hold on to God's unchanging hand, because God never changes.
Whenever I feel like things aren't going right and I lean on Him, He makes it straight.
In my personal life, He has just been incredibly, incredibly faithful and has come through. And He hasn't always come through with the things I ask specifically for, but He's always come through with that sense of peace.
I don't understand how people can live without the thought of that there is something bigger there and that it loves you no matter what you do or what you say or how you are, you know, how you live, that it's there, that God is there and He's holding on to you.
He's been there for me. That's why I know that I can depend on Him. God has never let me down, not once has He ever let me down.
God reassures us in His Word. I mean, the Bible is the proof right there. It's the answer that we need.
Somehow He always seems to know much better than I the way things are supposed to go. So I know that He's there, and I have that assurance, not just through His Word, but through also personal experience and depending on Him and having Him come through every time.
How many of you know tonight that there is a God in heaven who saves, who delivers, and who heals? Do you know that here tonight? Come on. God's love for you goes on and on. When other hearts have failed, this love forgave. From Calvary's cross, where that love was nailed, but you must believe He wants the best for you, though your prayers have yet to show. So let your heart be strong and your faith arise as I give you what I know. Well, I know there's a God in heaven who saves, who delivers, and heals. For He gave His Son, the Lamb of God. He's the Savior, the Scripture. Tonight, saved, delivered, and healed. Amen. Anybody out there? Night and day, He thinks of you. He hurts to see you cry. He wants for you, brother, He hopes for you. Sister, you're always on God's mind. So trust His heart and lean on Him, and let the Father lead the way. Many things of God I still don't know, but through the years I've learned to say. There's a God in heaven, and He saves, He delivers, and He heals. For He gave His Son, the Lamb of God. He's the Savior, the Scripture reveals. We are gonna set aside all our doubts, set aside all to that which is real. God's word doesn't sway. That's why still today I'm standing safe.
peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed all the day long. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, going about doing good and healing all who were oppressed of the devil. But God was with him, and God is with you tonight. That's why I can sing that I know. There's a God. Before you leave, you can be saved, delivered, and healed. If you believe that, give the Lord a praise offering tonight, everybody.
This next song was actually an old hymn I recorded for the 1995 Young Messiah Christmas Tour. The song came out so good that we decided to put it on the new record I was working on at the time. Then, of course, came time to do the video. Because it was about the life and death, resurrection of Jesus Christ, we thought we might go to Israel and film an authentic period piece there. That would, of course, entail recreating the crucifixion, and I just thought that it would be a bit too visually heavy for the song. Plus, it's been done before so many times. To me, the song felt happy and uplifting, and maybe because I did it as a Christmas song on the Young Messiah Tour, it always reminded me of Christmas. And then it hit me, let's just do the video like a Christmas song. I mean, I've always loved the movie It's a Wonderful Life, so I thought if we could find a little town somewhere that looked like that movie town, it would be great. But we still had the heavy parts of the song to deal with when it came to for the crucifixion. So I thought maybe we could take the small town idea all the way through the video with little kids doing a Christmas play as a secondary storyline. All of a sudden, it was all coming together. All we needed was a quaint little town with snow. We located the perfect place. Georgetown, Colorado, just outside of Denver. We'll shoot it in January while the Christmas decorations are still up. People will love it. There was only one problem. 3 days before the shoot, there was 2 feet of snow on the ground, but the day of the shoot, the temperature went up to 65 and all the snow melted. I mean, gone. I mean, we had a church choir coming, a horse and sleigh, and 65 degree weather. So we had to rent snow machines from a local ski resort to create snow just for the video. They brought in 4,100-pound blocks of ice and 16 dump trucks full of snow. Okay, interesting note, the snow blowers could only blow the snow so high in the air. So if you notice, the bottom half of all the buildings have beautiful holiday snowdrifts, while the top half is suspiciously void of snow. So come join me now in unseasonably warm Georgetown, Colorado, as we tell the story of the life, death, resurrection of Jesus Christ with my first ever recorded hymn from the Riot album, or as I like to call it, the Righteous Invasion of Truth record. Here's Amen.
story about my Jesus. Amen. Amen. See the little baby lying in the manger on Christmas morning. I can see him by the seashore, talking to those fishermen. He was making them disciples. Amen. Amen. Now he's riding to Jerusalem. They nailed him to a cross. It is finished, he had said. Then in a borrowed tomb, the Lamb of God lay dead. But then early Sunday morning, I said early Sunday morning, see, just before the sun came over the eastern sky, the trees began to rattle, and the birds began to fly, and the earth started to rumble, and the stone was rolled away. Then Jesus Christ, the Son of God, he arose.
He arose.
He arose.
He arose.
He arose.
He arose.
He walked alive out of the grave, and everybody said, somebody praise him, say,
amen, to me means so be it.
It's actually a declaration of saying, God has done it, I believe it, and that settles it.
To me, it means amen. Yes, you're going in the right direction, that's it.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life.
That was the only way that the sin could be paid for. He had to be God in order to pay the price. He had to be man in order to be the perfect sacrifice.
But how could God really, really understand what we're going through unless he had come in the form of man? And how would we really relate to God unless he had come in the form of man?
Sometimes we think of Jesus as someone who was untouchable. But I don't read in the Gospels of anyone who was afraid to approach Jesus. He was very touchable.
It's not like he sent an angel. It's not like he created something and sent. He really sent part of himself. He sent his Son.
The whole fact of his birth is representing life, and that's what he's brought to mankind, is bringing life. And that's what it really means to me, is life.